How are you? Today we will try to study and evaluate the poem My Own True Family, written by Ted Hughes. He is a pretty modern poet, and most of his imagery is used in his poem are of violent nature. But this poem has a different connotation, My Own True Family, where we feel very comfortable. Ted Hughes is a poet laureate since 1984 up till his death. Rajkovi chilo. Now, we try to read this poem at first and try to understand what is the implication or significance of the poem. In the present context, the poem is highly relevant. Where there is deforestation or outrage on nature, this poem is strictly relevant. Because if nature is outraged, nature will definitely take vengeance or revenge. And today is the spread of dreadful coronavirus is also, or maybe called one of the revengers of nature, because we are destroying nature at mindlessly. Now come to the poem. Once I crept in an oak wood. The poem is, the entire poem is a dream vision. Boy or the narrator narrates that once he crept in an oak wood, a jungle, oggacher jungle is polish polish. I was looking for a stag, and he was searching for a stag. He had stag, which apparently means a male deer, stands for the ideal forest or ideal nature. It stands for ideal nature. I met an old woman there, but instead of coming across a stag, he met an old woman. An old woman stands for decrepitude. All noblistic and rag. This expression, all noblistic and rag, this metaphoric expression is symbolic of the poor and exploited state of nature. This metaphoric expression is symbolic of the poor and exploited state of nature. Human beings have been exploiting nature mindlessly since time immemorial, since the inception of civilization. But they don't know that nature has its limit. It's not limitless. And man must restrain his greed. She said, I have your secret here inside my bag. This noble lady, a woman who stands for the poor and exploited state of nature, shows a bag that the whole secret about the narrator or about the boy who entered the forest or the oak wood jungle had in her bag. See, it's very curious to see that the poem. The first line ends with the word stag, the second line ends with the word rag, and the third line ends with the word bag. So there is an end line. It's a pattern. The poem is written with a specific pattern of end line. And other stanzas, when you will see that the same pattern is maintained throughout the poem. This brings out the skill in writing poetry. Then she began to cackle and I began to quake. She began to cackle. Cackles mean cackle kar hasa, shabd kar hasa. And the narrator began to quake. So that is an alliteration. Cackle and quake. The same repetition of the same sound. And it creates, instead of creating musical effect, it's created, here it creates a very horrific or horrible effect in the mind of the narrator. She opened up her little bag and I came twice away. As she opened the bag, she came twice away. That means he came twice away. That means he regained his inner consciousness. He regained his inner consciousness. The initial consciousness impelled him to enter into the forest in search of a stag, but this inner consciousness made him aware of the more state of nature. Surrounded by a staring tribe, he tied to a stick. He was surprised to see that he was tied to a stick or a cord. As the woman shook her back, they said, "We are the oak trees and your own true family." So the part of nature, here oak trees have been personified. The process of personification continues because the oak trees can speak. So they claim to be the familiar member of the narrative. We are chopped down. But they regret that they are being chopped down constantly, mindlessly, cruelly. We are torn up. Severed, তাদেরকে কেটে ফেলা হচ্ছে, ছিঁড়ে ফেলা হচ্ছে. You do not blink an eye. But man, this narrator stands for a man of conscience. You stand alone. You don't protest against these atrocities or outrageous act on nature. Unless you make a promise now you are going to die. This line brings out the violent imagery about which I am talking about, of taking this poem. Because nature, two words work, nature has an imamming effect. Nature is a mother figure, imams the womb. But to hardy, nature has both tooth and claw. That means that it can attack if it eats, is attacked. If nature is attacked mindlessly, nature also pounces upon those attackers. So here, this line also brings out hardy's attitude. That unless you make a promise now you are going to die. Nature is determined to exterminate the entire human civilization from this planet if men continue to cut trees at random. Here also see family, die, I dies, end rhyme, continues. Wherever you see an oak tree fell, you see that this, the lines are in the inverted comma. That is the direct speech of the oak tree. And here oak trees have been personified. Whenever you see an oak tree fell, swear now you will plant too. So they don't protest against their felling or cutting, but they demanded that if one tree is cut, two must be two must be planted. Otherwise, the entire forest will be vanished from this planet. And the whole planet will face extinction. Unless you swear, unless you pledge, it is shapath now. The black oak bark, again this black oak bark is symbolic of the poor state of nature. Will wrinkle over you. Tomake pechiye dhorbe and root you among the oaks where you were born but never knew, and engraved among the roots. Engraved the narrator among the roots. This is the direct Chaitanya. And this brings out the tooth and claw aspect of nature. That if nature is treated cruelly, mindlessly, nature will also take revenge. Nature will also take revenge upon human beings by spreading fearful viruses or by spreading virulent attack on virulent attack against humanity, against the human beings who claim to be the civilized beings on earth. This was my dream. Now you come to know the fact the entire poem is in a state of dream. This was my dream beneath the boughs. Boughs means branches of the trees. The dream that altered me. This dream has a reformative effect. This dream transformed the mind of the man and inspired in him a sympathy and empathy for with the sylvan world, with the plant, with the trees, because they have their own contributions. When I came out of the Oakwood, now these two lines are the inner realizations and observations of the man, of the boy, or the narrator who entered into the Oakwood. When I came out of the Oakwood, back to human company. Now, he returned to human society. My walk was the walk of a human child, but my heart was the of a tree. Though he walks like a human being, his mind is with the trees. That's why I'm telling you the sympathy for and empathy with trees, with the sylvan world. So this is how the poem ends. The concrete message of that poem is that if you cut one tree, plant two trees before, because this is how only nature can be saved. Nature can be saved. And if nature is not saved, the total human civilization will fail extermination or extinction. So that's why the poem is highly relevant in the present context, where human beings indulge in cutting trees or rampaging nature for the benefit of for their material benefits. Now there are some comprehension exercises. See that creeping in an oak wood, the poet was looking for a. I'll tell you only the answer. Goat, rhino, stag, buffalo. It will be stag. Whenever an oak tree fell, the number of trees the poet must plant is. It will be true. The answer, right answer, will be true. When the poet came out of the oak, his heart was that of a tree. Now there are two folks. The old woman held the poet's secrets in her little bag. It's true. And the supporting statement that you will supply, the supporting statement that I have everything, she said, I have your secret here inside my little bag. The tree tribe said the poet is bothered to see chopping down of oak trees. The tree tribe said that the poet is bothered to see. It's totally false, because he blinked an eye. He connived at the fault of the human beings of cutting trees at random. So it will be a false sentence. The poet never came out of the open tree. It is also false. And the supporting sentence, when I return. There are three questions. Questions are the when did the poet come twice? You see, and you will have to chalk out those answers and send me to the comment box. I will check it after the opening of the school. Now, see some pattern. This is the paradigm. The L1, first stanza, stab, line 2 ends with rag, line 3 ends with bag. Second stanza, line 1 ends with quake, line 2 ends with awake, line 3 ends with stick. Third stanza, L1, lines ends with family, familiar, or whatever, for the sake of rhyming, I and die. So this is the pattern. End rhyme is a pattern in which the poem, the whole poem is written. Some vocabulary: stag means male deer, nobly, unsteady, swear, promise, altered, changed, rag, word up. Stag, male hori, kana purush hori, swear, shapoth neoa, unsteady mane not bole, artha parchen, altered, poriborton, changed, rag, that means worn, torn pieces, chhara, tuloka, kekka, the sound of a hen, মোরগের মতন ডাকা অথবা এখানে খ্যাপ খ্যাপ করে আসা. কুয়েক মিন্স ট্রেম উইল কাম. সামন ইনসার্ট হিয়ার সারাউন্ডেড, সরি, স্টেক, স্টাউট, পোল, শক্ত খুঁটি. চক ডাউন মিন্স কাট ডাউন, কেটে ফেলা. চড়া সিভের, ছিঁড়ে ফেলা. প্রমিস প্লেজ. This word chop down, turn up, when we'll promoted, when we'll pass the exam and we'll read in class 11, you will see that is a poem called written by killing a tree. So the killing up, you will see these words. Bark means outer covering of a tree. Wrinkles means crease, pochkan. This is all about the poem. Okay, thank you for listening to me, and thank you for your patience. Don't avoid the classes, try to attend the classes every day. This will definitely benefit you.